the morning, in the evening, praise Him every day. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to another episode in the Hereafter series, where we began discussing the delights and the rewards and the descriptions of paradise. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant you and I the highest levels of paradise. Now we know when the people are about to enter Jannah, their forms will change. Their physical forms will change. And so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that everyone who enters paradise will be in the image of Adam alayhi salam, 60 cubits tall, and that people keep getting shorter and shorter after that moment. And this is reported by Sahih Muslim. Furthermore, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, their form will be like that of a single person after the image of Adam alayhi salam, 60 cubits tall. We also know that the people of paradise, they won't spit or blow their noses or excrete, and they won't have any kind of filth that they encounter in this life. Furthermore, the people of paradise, they will not sleep. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, sleep is the brother of death. The people of paradise will not sleep. And so when we think about paradise, it is different than this world in so many ways. And we cannot begin to imagine, despite all of the descriptions that we have of paradise, we cannot begin to imagine the rewards and the different world of paradise. And so the delights of Jannah are also beyond imaginable. The rewards of paradise are beyond what we can describe in mere words. And so when we talk about paradise and the rewards of paradise, we have to remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us of the rewards of paradise often in the Quran for a reason. Most people, when they hear about a delight or a promise, if it is not in front of them, it is difficult for them to give up something immediate and something temporary for that which will come later, let alone something that will come after their death. And so most people want instant gratification. They want the reward immediately. And so promising them paradise, for them it takes a lot of effort because it's something that comes after death and it is not immediate. And so as human beings, some of us have this weakness where we simply want instant gratification. We are impatient and are not willing to sacrifice or compromise in the current day and age, in the now, for later. And so we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who strive for paradise and believe firmly in the rewards of paradise and end up in the highest levels of paradise. Now the rewards of paradise are beyond what we can describe. The rewards are unimaginable. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us again and again and again of the rewards of Jannah, in order for us to be motivated to attain these rewards. Now think for a moment, ask yourself this following question. Ask yourself, what is the greatest or most enjoyable thing you've done in this world? And oftentimes when I ask this question in seminars and workshops, the responses vary. Some people will say the most enjoyable thing they've done is some kind of adventure or some kind of mountain hiking or skydiving or something thrilling. Other people will say they enjoy going out with their families. That's the most enjoyable thing for them. Other people will say eating or sleeping or something a lot less uncommon. And so most people, they have something that they really enjoy doing. It is their desire. And so it's hard for them to give it up. But when you think of the most enjoyable experience of your life, something that you've done in your life that is the most amazing thing that you've ever done. Now ask yourself about that scenario. How long did it last? How long could you retain the happiness of that scenario? And so the moments that we go through in this world, the desires that we fulfill in this world, they're all temporary, regardless of what it is. Whether it's eating or sleeping or going somewhere you enjoy going, anything you do in this life, any desire you fulfill in this world is temporary. And that is one of the biggest differences between this life and the next life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, مَا عِنْدَكُمْ يَنْفَدْ وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ بَاقٍ. What you have with you is temporary, and what is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is eternal, it is lasting. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nahl, verse 96, that what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has is lasting. So paradise is lasting. So the things you will enjoy in paradise, the desires you indulge in, are lasting. But the ones we enjoy in this life are temporary. So think for a moment about that which you experience in this world. And for example, I will give you a personal experience. A few years ago, I was in the Caribbean islands, and I was on an empty beach. The entire coast was empty. And on the beach, the weather was perfect. And so after I prayed, I reclined back on a chair. And when I reclined back on this chair, I looked forward, and all I can see was the ocean, the beautiful and vast ocean. And the colors of the ocean were amazing. All the shades of green and blue you can imagine, and everything in between. The aquatic colors, turquoise, teal, all of these colors were mixed together. And so I was staring at this beautiful ocean, relaxing on this chair, and there was a palm tree right next to me, leaning over the chair as if to offer some fruits. And the sand was pure. The sand was clean. There was no dirt in there. There were no sediments. There were no rocks or shells or trash. And so I was sitting there enjoying this perfect breeze, the perfect weather. And I could hear in the far distance the sound of the birds. And I'm sitting there looking at the ocean and experiencing the sound of the waves crashing in this ocean. And as this perfect experience was taking place, and I was sitting there in perhaps one of the most enjoyable moments of my life, as I was sitting there, I realized to myself, regardless of how great the moment was, it would cease to exist. It was temporary. And so everything we enjoy in this life is temporary. And yet Jannah, paradise, is eternal. Paradise, we cannot begin to imagine what eternal is. Our human minds are so limited. And so when you think about the things of this world, the pleasures of this life, you cannot begin to compare them to the hereafter. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us several different ways that this life is different than the next life. So one of those ways is when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the examples that the pleasures of this dunya are fleeting, are temporary. They will cease to exist. They are not lasting. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nisa, verse 77, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ مَتَاعُ الدُّنْيَا قَلِيلٌ. Say, the enjoyment of this world is little, is temporary. وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لِمَنِ اتَّقَى. And the hereafter, it is better for those who have taqwa, those who have God consciousness. They do what they are enjoined to do, and they stay away from that which is forbidden. So the hereafter is eternal. Imam Muslim reports that the Prophet ﷺ said, by Allah, this